Good evening. Three people are dead and there are grave fears for at least one more after fire tore through a boarding house at Newtown in Sydney's inner west. Residents were forced to leap from windows to escape the blaze. Police are now treating it as murder.
A fire so fierce there was nothing anyone could do but run.
Oh my God, is someone in there?
Without warning, this Newtown boarding house erupting in flames. 1 o'clock in the morning, residents scrambling to escape onto Albemarle Street.
I had enough time to put some pants on, I had enough time to put some shoes on, and then the power went out. I saw an 80-year-old gentleman on the ground who'd had to jump out of his window, so he's broken his ankles. We had to carry him out of there.
One of my good friends was taken out with his legs on fire last night.
8 residents escaped the burning building, 3 taken to hospital, and tonight one man is fighting for life.
This huge explosion shook the whole house. It sounded like a bomb going off.
One guy got blown out through a window in his room. He's gone to hospital.
3 men didn't make it out, and police say this blaze was deliberately lit.
Some type of accelerant has been used. We're treating this as a murder.
We didn't all survive. There were about 12 people living in this house.
More than a dozen detectives took over the area, the crime scene extending multiple blocks.
Detectives are now pleading with the owner of this boarding house to come forward. Officers have been to multiple properties searching for him, but say he is simply uncontactable.
And we'd like that gentleman to come forward as a matter of priority.
And amid the tragedy, there's also anger. Residents say the property was a disaster waiting to happen.
You know, it was a very poorly maintained property. Because it's not a registered boarding house, never ever has any inspections.
And Lauren Tomasi is at the scene in Newtown tonight. Lauren, you have new information on the landlord.
Peter, can reveal the landlord, Albert Wong, was fined in 2019 for not completing a fire safety check on this premises. Mr Wong is not a suspect of police, but officers are yet to speak with him and he is yet to come forward. In terms of the situation here tonight, well, officers and fire crews are still unable to access the second story of this property amid fears of collapse. The work to stabilise that building is expected to extend into the night. Pete?
Lauren, thank you.